All right, guys, 21-15-9, dumbbell hang squat clean, handstand push-ups. 3, 2, 1, go. So in that 21-15-9 hang squat cleans with the dumbbells and handstand push-up workout, what I'd really advise is on those dumbbell hang squat cleans, you've got to have good technique. Use your legs and your hips to get those things moving, your arms to pull yourself down under the dumbbells. It's light enough, if you're strong enough, that you can muscle it up with your arms, and that may be a little bit faster and feels better metabolically, but your arms are gonna pay the price when you go onto that wall for the handstand push-up. So you wanna save your arms for the handstand push-up. So utilize the hips and the legs as much as possible on that dumbbell hang squat clean. And then on the handstand push-ups, these were deceptively hard. I've done Diane before, can usually run through Diane pretty well. I died on this workout. That squat cleans, that shrug and holding the dumbbells in my hands tired my arms out. So it would have been better if I would have paced better on that first set of 21. So kind of know where you're at. Expect it to be worse than Diane, a workout that most of us have done and we're used to. Expect it to be worse than that. Pace yourself a little bit better heading out of the gate on that first set of 21 so you don't die on the second or third round.
Right now is we get the kids on a box in a pike position, so we want their hips high, their knees close to the edge of the box, and their hands close to the edge of the box, and we ask them to tap the top of their head, not the forehead, but the top of the head to the ground, come to full extension with the arms, and that gives them some weight-bearing load to practice that handstand push-up. So you saw some kids against the wall doing handstand push-ups, some of them can string them together, some were just doing one or two, and then others were scaling off of the box.
Our butts.